Welcome to another in the series of demonstrations designed to get you quickly up to speed with what's new in NXCAM. This video will demonstrate how you can now graphically jog the robotic arm and easily define machining poses. Once defined, poses can be used as start and end positions in operations. Previously, you were required to create a user-defined event and manually enter numeric values copied from the Machining Axis Positions dialog box, which was difficult and time-consuming. We'll begin by simulating the robotics machine tool. Select the robotic program. Click Simulate Machine. Click Play. Both sides of the blade are polished with no collisions or singularities occurring. Click Close in the Simulation Control Panel. Next, we'll view the existing poses. Select the Assembly Navigator tab. Select the Polishing Station checkbox to display the station. Select the Operation Navigator tab. With the Polished Blade Rough 1 program selected, click Jog and Poses in the ribbon bar. This is an environment that allows you to jog the robot, including the head, tool, and other devices in the robotic cell, and capture poses graphically. Previously, the Move Spindle, Move Axis, and Setting options were displayed only in the Preview Motion dialog box of the Machine Tool Navigator. Now these options are also displayed in the new Robot Jog and Poses dialog box, along with the new Poses list. Because a program group is selected, all defined poses are listed whether or not they're used in an operation. Notice the Use As column is blank. Previously, the head holder and tool were not displayed on the machine tool. Now the head holder and tool used by the selected operation or the first operation in the selected group, as in this case, are displayed. Select the Move Spindle About Part checkbox to display the graphics handles. Select Tool Change 1 in the Poses list. Tool Change 1 positions the head near the rack. Select P1 in the Poses list. P1 positions the head above the part. Click OK in the Robot Jog and Poses dialog box. Now we'll add a pose to an operation. Poses may be added when a program or operation is selected. Poses cannot be added if an object in the Operation Navigator is not selected. In this example, we'll add a pose when an operation is selected. Select the Rough 1 Side 2 operation. Click Jog and Poses in the ribbon bar. Select the center point of the hole on the top face of the positioner. Select the Z arrowhead and the top face of the positioner. Drag the arrowhead up a distance of approximately 300. Click Add Pose. Type P2 in the Name column and press the Enter key. Next, we'll use the pose. Poses may be specified in operations as Start, End, or Start and End. Notice that the Home pose is currently used as Start and End for this operation. Right-click P2 and select Use as End Pose. Home is now specified as the Start pose and P2 is specified as the End pose. Click OK. Click Apply Rules. Click OK in the Toolpath Processing dialog box. With Rough 1 Side 2 still selected, click Simulate Machine. Click Play. The toolpath ends at P2. Click Close. Now, we'll edit a pose used by multiple operations. You may remove, rename, or update poses when a single program or operation is selected. When a program is selected, All operations in that program that inherit the edited pose are affected. When an operation is selected, you may only edit poses that were defined locally and used by that operation alone. A pose used by multiple operations, that is, one that is inherited from a parent object, cannot be edited when an operation is selected. In this example, we'll edit the home pose, which is used by both operations. To do this, we'll select the program containing both operations. Select the Polish Blade Rough 1 program. Click Jog and Poses. Select Home in the Poses list. Rotate the head about the XZ axis, approximately negative 35 degrees. Drag the Z arrowhead, approximately 100. Right-click Home, and notice that you can remove, rename, and update the pose. Select Update. Click Yes in the Edit Poses dialog box. Click OK in the Robot Jog and Poses dialog box. With Polish Blade Rough 1 still selected, click Apply Rules. Click OK in the Toolpath Processing dialog box. Now we'll see how the home pose has been edited for both operations while still being used as start and end in the Rough 1 Side 1 operation and start in the Rough 1 Side 2 operation. Select the Rough 1 Side 1 operation. Click Jog and Poses. Select Home in the Poses list. Notice that the home pose is at the position and orientation you specified and is being used as the start and end for this operation. Also notice that P2 does not appear in the Add Pose list for this operation. This is because P2 was created inside the Rough 1 Side 2 operation. Click OK. Select the Rough 1 Side 2 operation. Click Jog and Poses. Select Home in the Poses list. Notice that the home pose is at the position and orientation you specified and is being used as the start for this operation. Click OK. Now we'll edit a pose used by a single operation. When an operation is selected, you may only edit poses defined locally and used by that operation alone. With Rough 1 Side 2 selected, click Jog and Poses. Select P2 in the Poses list. Rotate the head about the XZ axis, approximately 30 degrees. Right-click P2, and notice that additional options appear. Because you are editing a pose defined locally and used by a single operation, you can also specify it as a start pose, end pose, both start and end pose, or choose not to use it at all. Right-click P2 and select Update. Click Yes in the Edit Poses dialog box. Right-click P1 and notice that you cannot edit this pose. That is, you cannot remove, rename, and update. This is because P1 was defined in the parent program. Right-click Home, and notice that you cannot edit this pose. Again, this is because Home was defined in the parent program. Click OK in the Toolpath Processing dialog box. This concludes the demonstration of how you can graphically jog the robotic arm and easily define machine poses. Thank you.